understand why a person tells you something like, I never lost China appetite, I don't have appetite. But they go ahead to order things. I don't have appetite. I think I just eat sausage. Let me just eat like 2 pairs. Like 2 pairs? Yeah, let me just eat 2 pairs, maybe. Well, what should I drink? I'm not even thirsty. Do you have African tea? African tea. I don't like that ginger. Just give me spices. Before you know, the person has consumed. And you're like, and then after, like, ah, this thing is also. Anyway, I've just tried. They have just tried. But you don't blame them. Chapter begins at home. I come from a family where eating was not a choice, it was chance. You know where you're like 25 in the family and they're serving food, you're monitoring and evaluating the situation. Even your fingers are already, you know, somehow psychologically your hands are already in the saucepan. You find the people moving like this because they're waiting for the food. They're like, hey, how are you? Those days were tough. And you can know a person who was raised in such a family. How? They eat meat first. When you go for a party, people who are raised in good families, nuclear families, they have no challenges. They can afford to eat other food even if the meat stays. They can throw it away or eat it. The one in extended family. You first extend your gratitude to the meat. Eat it first. Why? I'd reached a point where there was a family member. They were so humble. They were so poor. Their father said it was Christmas. And Christmas, everybody was supposed to eat meat or chicken. What the father did, he gave them their portion. He went and cut out a newspaper with chicken and pasted it on the wall. He said, imagine. That is your future. Just eat. They ate the portion, then after I gave them toothpick, let the neighbors know.